So first of all, what is a unit circle? Unit circle is nothing crazy. It's just a circle with radius equal 1. Unit circle just means we have a circle with radius equal 1. R-A-D-I-U-S. Okay? It's nothing crazy. It's just a circle with radius equal 1. And we give it a cool name, unit circle. Unit circle. Okay? So here it is. X-axis, y-axis. So let's draw a unit circle. So basically, it's a circle with the radius. So if I draw a radius right here, the radius equal 1. Okay, guys? So here it is. Let me show you something pretty cool. Okay? So now, guys, now from here, I'm going to draw a triangle. Okay, so once again, imagine you have a terminal arm right here. This is your terminal arm. How do we draw a triangle out of it? We always connect the terminal arm to x-axis. You guys see that? Mm-hmm. Okay, so now check this out. Because any point has x-coordinate and y-coordinate, right? Any point. Okay, so that means what, guys? That means the length right here, you know what, I'm going to use another color. Yellow. So the length right here is what? X, right? Nothing crazy. Now, use another color. So, the length right here will represent what? Y. Right? Nothing crazy. For example, I'm going to give you an example. Let's say if I have a point 3 and 2. That means what, guys? If I draw a triangle, that means when x is 3, that means what? Here we have 3. 1, 2, 3, right? 1, 2, 3. Right? So that's why the x-coordinate is 3. When y is 2, that means what? Here. 1, 2. Right? That's why the y-coordinate is 2. Right? So if I were to ask you, hey, what's the length? How long is this? You would say the length of this is what? 3, right? Yeah, easy as that. So if I were to ask you, what is the, I'm going to use another color. Now, what is the length for the y right here? Well, so the length here would be what? 2, right? Length would be 2. Right? Nothing crazy. So once again, if the x coordinate for any point, we have an x coordinate, right? So x coordinate means here, the length of this would just be x, right? It's like this. If the x coordinate here is 3, the length here should be 3, right? Same thing. X here, that means the length here is x, right? Now, same thing as here. If the y coordinate here is y, that means the length of this segment should be y, right? It's like this here as well. When the y coordinate here is 2, that means what? The length of this segment is 2, right? Here it is. I'm going to derive something really cool. Now, so guys, Now here we have a reference angle. What color should I use? Let's use pink. Okay, so guys, here, once again, reference angle is the angle between terminal arm and x-axis. So this right here is the reference angle, right? Reference angle is the angle between the terminal arm and x-axis. So here we have a reference angle of, say, theta. And once again, reference angle is always the most important angle we deal with when we talk about trigonometry. Okay, so here it is. Look at this triangle. Here we have radius of length 1. Because what? Because here we have a unit circle with radius equals 1. Okay, and in this triangle, the length of this portion is x. The length of this portion is y. Okay, so guys, check this out. I'm going to derive something really, really cool. So guys, look at sine theta. Look at this reference angle. And let's write an expression for sine theta. So sine theta goes like this, so cot toa, right? So cot toa. So sine is opposite over hypotenuse. Okay, so guys, in this triangle right here, now, when we look at this reference angle, who is the opposite? Opposite to the reference angle is y. Right, is y. Now, hypotenuse, well, hypotenuse is always the one across from 90 degrees, right? The one across from 90 degrees is always called the hypotenuse. So in this case, hypotenuse is this guy, which happens to be the radius, which is 1. Okay, hypotenuse is 1. Oops. Is 1. Okay, guys? Yeah, so once again, according to this reference angle, opposite is y. Hypotenuse across from 90 degrees is 1. Okay, check this out, guys. So, in a unit circle, if I rearrange this, so in a unit circle, y equals what? Because multiply the 1 over to the other side. Actually, we don't even have to, because y divided by 1 is just what? It's just y, right? And because anything divided by 1 is just itself. So y divided by 1 is just y. So y equals sine theta. Okay, so I'm gonna put down some notes here. In a unit circle, the y coordinate represents sine theta. Okay? Now, here it is. Guys, now, what if we write an expression for cosine theta? When we look at it, by looking at this triangle, let's do cosine theta and see what we can come up with. So cosine theta is, so cot toa, cosine is adjacent over hypotenuse, right? So looking at this reference angle right here, adjacent to this reference angle is the x. Hypotenuse, once again, is the one across from 90 degrees, which is the radius 1. Ah, so guys, x divided by 1, anything divided by 1 is itself. So x equals cosine theta. So in a unit circle, the x coordinate now is represented by what? Cosine theta. Are we cool, guys? So in a unit circle, the y coordinate, any point on the unit circle, guys, any point on the unit circle, the y coordinate is going to represent sine theta. the x coordinate is going to represent cosine theta. Are we cool? Guys, that's what we just derived, right? It's actually quite easy to derive. Okay? So guys, so let's put this information on the unit circle. So I'm going to draw the unit circle again. Okay, a unicircle with radius, with radius equal 1. Okay guys, and now for any point here, and guys here we have a reference angle, right? So theta right here. So we got x coordinate, y coordinate. Now, here it is. X coordinate now. Oops, let's do this again. I need more space. So guys, guess what? Now, x-coordinate can be represented by what? Cosine theta. Cosine theta, right? For a unit circle. And then the y-coordinate represents what? Sine theta. Sine theta. Can you see that? So x-coordinate can be represented by cosine theta. Y-coordinate can be represented by sine theta. Okay? Check this out. Now, check this out. Oh, but by the way, what does this mean? What does this mean? So for example, how do we apply that? So if I were to draw a unit circle, okay? Now, let's say right here. Okay, so guys, here it is. X-coordinate can be represented by cosine theta. Okay. Y-coordinate can be represented by sine theta. So check this out, guys. Now, guys, if I were to, let's say if this angle right here is 30 degrees, that means what? For 30 degrees, for any point on a unit circle, by the way, unit circle is radius equal 1, right? Radius right here equal 1. So guys, how do we find the coordinate at this point? How do we find the coordinate at this point? Easy. This is what we do, guys. We just input 30 degree as theta. So put 30 degree right here. 30 degree right here. Okay? Yeah. So guys, cosine 30 degree, what's the value? Well, special triangle again. 30 degree, 60 degree, 90 degree. Ratio goes like this, 1 to 2 to root 3, right? So guys, cosine 30 degree is adjacent over hypotenuse. So it's root 3 over 2. Yeah? Now, Sine 30 degree is opposite of hypotenuse, so it's 1 over 2. So guys, guess what? For this point on the unit circle with radius equal 1, if here is 30 degree, we can actually right away find the coordinate for this point, which is root 3 over 2 as the x coordinate, 1 over 2 as the y coordinate. How cool is that?